phosphoglyceraldehyde or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. It is isomer with DHAP. It means DHAP dihydroxyacetone phosphate and PGAL. These two are isomers. So there is a conversion of PGAL to DHAP, DHAP to PGAL, vice versa conversion. So by triose isomerase enzyme. Then the PGAL involved in the glycolysis steps. It means glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate or phosphoglyceraldehyde gone to the reaction of dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation that resulted to production of 1,3-bisphosphoglyceraldehyde. 1,3-bisphosphoglyceraldehyde. So glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate oxidized into 1,3-bisphosphoglyceraldehyde by losing of two hydrogen molecules. The two hydrogen molecules are absorbed by NAD plus, then NADH2 is reduced. It means here there is a energy production reaction. So it is a energy giving reaction. NADH plus H plus is released in the presence of the enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. Then 1,3-bisphosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Here ATP is released. The ATP is released by using of ADP and PI. This reaction is mediated by enzyme phosphoglycokinase. Phosphoglycokinase. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde consists the carbon number is 3. So the total number of carbon are how many? 3 here. And then it can converted into 2-phosphoglycerate in the presence of the enzyme mutase. So the mutase enzyme mediated the reaction. The 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate or 2-phosphoglyceraldehyde. Then in the reaction in the enzyme enolase. So the enolase mediate the reaction of formation of phosphoenol pyruvic acid, that is PEP, from 2-phosphoglycerate. So here phosphoenol pyruvic acid is produced from 2-phosphoglycerate. Here a mediated enzyme is enolase. Then what is the final product of the glycolysis? The final product of the glycolysis is pyruvic acid. So again here one ATP is synthesized at the last step of the glycolysis. You see here the PEP by taking of 1-phosphate group, it converted into pyruvic acid. So phosphoenol pyruvic acid by losing 1-phosphate, by lost 1-phosphate molecule, it turned into pyruvic acid. So the released phosphate molecule is added with ATP and that resulted to the production of ATP. So the ATP is released. So it means phosphoenol pyruvic acid, here the dephosphorylation reaction is carried out. Due to that it lost 1-phosphate molecule, the released phosphate molecule is added with ADP, then that converted into the ATP, adenosine triphosphate molecule, and here the pyruvic acid end product is released in metabolic pathway of glycolysis. Here the mediated enzyme is pyruvic kinase. Totally 10 steps are involved during the glycolysis. During the glycolysis, the glucose is converted into 2-5-uric acid molecule. How much of energy is required for the glycolysis? So, the required energy is, it means we are saying in the form of energetics. Energetics. It means how much of energy is required to carry out the all the reactions included in glycolysis means 2 ATPs are required. Where the 2 ATPs are required? At the first reaction and also at the third reaction. So there the 2 ATPs are required. And how much of energy is released here? Released energy during the partial oxidation of glucose means here how many NADH2s are released here. You see here when the triose sugar is involved into the glycolysis, one glycolysis cycle is carried out. And here another triose phosphate molecule also available. It means here also one glycolysis cycle is gone because these two are isomers. So for the one glucose molecule is involved in glycolysis is once, it means there is a production of 2 NADH2s, 2 NADHH+. Okay, so how many 2 NADH pluses are released and how many ATPs are released? The released ATPs are, you see here, one. Here one ATP is released and also at the end stage another ATP is released. But how many cycles are taken here? Two cycles are taken here. That's why how many ATPs? 4 ATPs are released during the glycolysis. 1 NADH2 is equivalent to how many ATPs production? 3 ATPs production. So how many NADH2s are released here? For 2 NADH2s, there is a production of 2 into 3 ATPs, 6 ATPs are released. But in direct, how many ATPs are released? The released ATPs are how many? So 4. So you add with 4 ATPs. Totally released ATPs are how many? 10 ATPs are released. But what is the net ATPs? How many net ATPs are released during the glycolysis means? How many are released? 10 are released. How many are required for doing of this procedure means? There are 2 ATPs are required. So you take the minus of 10 minus 2 ATPs. Total ATPs are 8 ATPs. It means the net ATPs are 8 ATPs. You see here, out of total release, 2 are required for initiation of the glycolysis. Then the total net ATPs released 8 ATPs. It means one molecule of glucose involved in the glycolysis reaction, there is a production of 8 ATP molecules.